A planet moves around the sun in nearly circular orbit. Its period of revolution, capital T, depends on radius of orbit, R, mass, M, of the sun, and the gravitational constant, G. Show dimensionally that T squared directly proportional to R cubed. So this is also one of the important problem in the dimensionally proving method. So here given that time period, revolution of time, it means the time taken to complete, suppose if this is sun, the time taken to complete a planet around the sun if it is a circular orbit. So this planet time period, so that planet time period we need to calculate by using dimensionally. Now they are already given the time period T is directly proportional to radius, depends on, means directly proportional to, so time period also proportional to mass, and the time period also proportional to gravitational constant capital G. These three together, if you can write that T directly proportional to, here it is R power A, I would like to take, since we don't know whether it is positive or negative, so we need to consider as a some powers. So time period directly proportional to R power A and M power B and G power C. And we can take it to proportionality, we can make it equal. By the time I can bring a constant K, dimensionless constant here, R power A and M power B and G power C. So let the K value goes to 1. So it will be the out of the equation. Now finally I can write that T equal to R power A and M power B and G power C. Now here the time to write the dimensions. So the dimensions of T, T is time period, so time period dimensions T itself, and the dimensions of R, radius, radius dimensions are nothing but meters, so we can write that in terms of length L. And we need to get the dimensions of G. So G is not known for us, but if you remember, gravitational force F equal to capital G times M1 M2 upon R square. This is Newton's gravitational law of gravitation force. Now from this you can write the G equal to F times R square upon M1 M2. They both are the mass. So G equal to the force, force units are the dimensional formula mLt power minus 2, and the R means length square upon M times M, mass, dimensions are the M times M. So from here we can get the dimensions of G. So I can write the dimension of the G by solving that M inverse and L cube and T power minus 2. So here the G became the dimensional constant. I forgot to mention that some constants are there, some are having the dimensions and some are not having the dimensions. So let me discuss it here. Constants which are not having dimensions, just like pi. Pi is a constant, it do not have any dimensions, and exponential e also do not having any dimensions, and some other constant just like gravitational constant, it is having the dimensions. So M inverse and L cube and the T inverse 2, it is a dimensional constant. Some constants do not have dimensions and some constants which are having the dimensions. So in that case, this gravitational constant comes under dimensional constant. or if you are finding difficult, just switch the back pages of the NCERT. There we will find that all these dimensions. Now I got the dimensions. Now what can I do? Now I have to substitute these dimensions in the above equation. Suppose if I call this is equation 1, now substitute dimensions in equation 1. Now if you can substitute dimensions in equation 1, the time dimensions t itself, we have to put the brackets, t equal to r dimensions. R dimensions means nothing but length l. So we can get l power a, and the mass dimensions here I forgot to write, mass m equal to capital M only. That is the mass dimensions. So mass is nothing but m, is capital M power b, and the g dimensions from here I derived that it is m power minus 1 l power 3 and t power minus 2 whole power c. Now we need to make it equal. So in that case, on the left hand side I'm going to change like this, m power 0 and l power 0 and t power 1. Since nothing is there, we can put that as 0. Anything power 0 goes to 1. So here already the time period t is given, so that we can take as t. On this right side, so I will rewrite the same, l power a and m power b, and here we can split that one, m power minus c and l power 3c and t power minus 2c. Now we can make it equating on the left hand side to right hand side, equating dimensions of m comma l comma t on both sides, equating dimensions of m comma l comma t on both sides. Now first let me equate m. So here on the m side, 0 equal to on here m side, on the right side m. So here m power b and m power minus c. So here I can get that as dimensions. If we can make it equal, m power 0 equal to, it is 0, don't confuse, m power 0 equal to, on the left hand side, m power b times m power minus c. So we are having the mathematical relations, when the bases are equal, power must be added. So we can add the power b minus c. So therefore 0 equal to b minus c. If we can make it equal, dimensions of the m on both sides. So here I can get that 0 equal to b minus c. Like that, if we can make it equal length l. Now length 0 equal to, on the right side having the l power a and l power 3c, it becomes a power 3c. Now if you can make it equal, time t equal to t power 1 equal to, on the right side it is having minus 2c. Now we will solve one by one. If I solve this, 1 equal to minus 2c, therefore c equal to minus 1 by 2. If I can substitute that in this equation to solve a, therefore a equal to minus 3c. Now I can put that 3 value at here. If this equation is down and c value at here, therefore a equal to minus 3 of minus 1 by 2, here a equal to 3 by 2. Now, from the first equation, here you can get b equal to c. Therefore, b equal to c value equal to minus 1 by 2. Therefore, we got the three equations a, b, c. The a, b, c. So, b equal to minus 1 by 2 and a equal to 3 by 2 and c equal to minus 1 by 2. Now, these three values we can substitute in the standard equation 1. So, a, b, c in 1. Therefore, a comma b comma c in equation 1. What is equation 1? T equal to k times m power, sorry, r power a, r power a and m capital M power b and capital G power c. So, therefore, T equal to k, dimensionless constant, and r power a value equal to how much? A equal to 3 upon 2 and m b power minus 1 by 2 and g c power c value also minus 1 by 2. C value minus 1 by 2. Minus 1 by 2. Therefore, T equal to k times r power 3 by 2 and these two values you bring it downstairs, m power 1 by 2 and g power 1 by 2. Now, what we need to prove? We need to prove that t square is directly proportional to r cube. So, to prove this t square is directly proportional to r cube, here I am having only t. So, what can I do? I can do the squaring on both sides. Okay. So, if I can take that squaring on both sides. So, t square equal to k times r whole power 3 by 2 and whole square upon m power 1 by 2 whole square and g power 1 by 2 whole square. Now this square gets cancels and here the square and the 2 gets cancelled. The final equation here I can get t square equal to k square times r cube upon m times g. If you can write that proportionality, that I can get t square is directly proportional to r cube. So this is what we need to prove finally. By dimensionally, the square of the, this is a very 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 important law. If you remember, this is one of the Kepler's law for planetary motion. Kepler said that for the planetary motion, the square of the time period of a planet is directly proportional to cube of the semi-major axis, means radius. So this is one of the very famous law for the planetary motions, that is t square is directly proportional to r cube. The square of the time period of a planet is directly proportional to cube of the semi-major axis. So that we proved by using dimensional analysis. So try to practice it more and try to get it.